I will have a conversation about how to digest spaghetti, and I will start off with my first slide. I will welcome you all to my presentation, and I will start off with the first slide, which is a little bit about my background. We will skip this really fast. I have a background in econometrics. And I'm involved with the Oracle developer and Ernst & Young. After that, I went to different clients implementing ERP from Oracle. 25 years I've done that. But if you see what clients I served, you can see all kinds of different business sectors, which are. Which have used Oracle ERP. If we go to the next slide, this is a summarization. My background is, in fact, the experience with Apple experience in the customer sphere and the professional experience in Oracle ERP. But lately, I was involved with the new Metro line, the Metro line that you probably took also to come here. And I will more elaborate on the issues that confronted me in my work on the basis of IT and the business and the influences that had on the business processes. If I came to Metro and Tram, 4 years ago, and what I saw was a spaghetti of connections. Not only connections, but there is much more spaghetti to be involved with. If we look to the tasks that were executed at Metro and Tram, we can see that there are quite a few things that happened. Design, implement, and rollout of high-band NMR network, Metropolitan Amsterdam. That was a new network built by the municipality from Amsterdam. And we had to build that because we had to make connections. And what we saw is that that if you connect not only by wire, but also on wireless systems, you need some technology to support it. If you look at the network Metro Amsterdam, you can maintain all assets with ServiceNow. ServiceNow is an application which does predictive asset management. So that's state of the art. It's like Oracle in the ERP, but ServiceNow is one of the suppliers of predictive asset management. So if something goes wrong on the end on your network, you can just see it, but you can also predict when it goes wrong. Yeah. So that's a technical solution for that. What we also did was migrate old networks all to the new network Metro Amsterdam. Network Metro Amsterdam is not only for Metro, but also for Metropolitan. So this is the first municipal network, which is also offered to other clients besides Metro itself. That's a new experience for in the Netherlands. We are the first one. It took some time to get there, but it's now in operation because the North-South line is in operation for half a year now. What we did is also implement and upgrade identical technical rooms. That was necessary because there was a lot of mess built up from historical events, but now we are up to new standards. And we implemented information and data security. If you can see here, you can see what partners were involved. You see Alstom, Thales, Siemens, which were in charge of the signaling control for the metro by Alstom. As you heard, probably the merger between Alstom and Siemens will not continue because they become monopolists if they in Europe, not in the world, but they have some issues with Chinese aspects. And you see that Thales was in charge of as a supplier for the network metro Amsterdam. What we also did is coverage of public coverage of telecom, and we were involved with all the four suppliers in the Netherlands to give all the passengers the public access to telecom. So those were the main aspects of my work at Metro and Tram. And now I want to get into a deeper overview and awareness of where comes spaghetti from. You know, if you have your network, your network itself is based on a certain amount of layers. And you see, they call it OSI layers. And on the left side, you see a kind of spaghetti within an OSI layer. And you see, when shifting from OSI to TCP/IP, it becomes a little bit more compressed and more simple. But still, it is very spaghetti-like. I give you another example. If we look at AV, we also have different codecs. So that's also an example of what kind of spaghetti can we encounter if you want to combine everything in one system, because I'm used to that coming from an Oracle world with ERP, you know, everything in Oracle, you know. As a customer, you don't need to worry about interfaces and stuff like that. So that was quite a surprise. And also in the spaghetti, we can see that there are within the AV. I'm not an AV professional, but I can see that there is also a lot of spaghetti available. Here you can see that for instance, SMPTE has a different frame rate worldwide, so you have to deal with that. If otherwise, you are not connecting. And there's a great document about 100 years ahead from that organization to tell you all about the new immersive media, AR, VR, which will explain how you can involve that in your analysis. What is also important, I think, a different standards within AV is at least that there is a standard for a precision clock synchronization. So there are some levels in that, but in 2002 and 2008, you see two versions of that that standard. So I think anyone can see that spaghetti is also available in the AV market, not only because of SMPTE and IEEE standards, but also, yeah, in the application market. I'm not aware of the AV applications, but I just took a marketing example. If you can see here on the left side, you see you get a reasonable, a simple picture of the domains that are covered. But if you in effect see in practice how many brands and logos are involved in offering only applications, then it's spaghetti, you know. You have to pick and choose which one suits you and how can you connect all those different applications with each other. So it's also a basis of spaghetti. Now, if we compare spaghetti business versus IT, you see that there are alignment challenges caused by difference in the stakeholders. You have your requirements, drivers, focus, and KPIs. They are different based on business and based on IT. You know, and domains and viewpoints. You have your service level agreements. You have different cultures between business and IT. You have a different language, abbreviations, codes, and standards. And you have a different environment. The business has another environment than IT has. So those are other examples of IT and business fragmentation. What you also see is if you try to analyze it, there is a systematic approach. So if you know what kind of architecture you can bring alive for you as a company, you can see that between those architectures, there are stakeholders of one of these architectures, and you have question mark between those architectures. Now, how can we solve the relation between those architecture? Because that's a challenge. I will explain that later, but I will first go into the next slide, because this slide is really an example of how enterprise architecture is dealing with those kinds of issues. Another example of spaghetti is the viewpoint. If we live in an environment and we have global aspects, we have national aspects, we have regional aspects, organizational aspects, divisional aspects, and individual aspects. And moreover, the individual aspect is very important to get to know how people decide upon things they want to solve. And I want to make you, I want to make a trip with you, not only by looking at IT, but also how do you as a person can have a certain thought about a problem and solve it. And that's why I want to encounter you with some other disruptions that will take place in the near future. Now, I stated here quite a lot of container disruptions, but that doesn't mean that it is disrupting you. You don't know, you know. So the spaghetti of container disruptions can also be a challenge to organize your business on a whole new scale. If you look at now, there are global issues, there are local issues, there are governmental issues. You can pick and choose one and see whether one of these container disruptions has impact on your business processes. Because if you want to stay in business, do you still want to have the same business processes? If not, you have to adapt. Yeah? So you can adapt and then try to involve one of these container disruptions and make a challenge out of it, so you get a bigger market share with your new business processes. I'm really focused on business processes because in Oracle we were used to work with reference models. Reference models, based on the reference models, you have your business processes. Based on your business processes, you have your procedures. Procedures is on a technical level, where the systems are, where the interfaces are, where the architecture is. The business processes are loosened from systems. That's really strict. So you don't involve systems with processes. You involve procedures with systems. I will come later in the next slide to explain that more evidently. Now, if someone has a question about one of these container disruptions, we can talk about it, how it involves your business. It's not evident for me as well, because I'm not aware of all those disruptions, what will happen to your business processes, but it's very intriguing to investigate that. Now, if we look to Oracle, for instance, or any other, you see also that vendors have different kinds of service delivery. So you can have your IT on premise. You have IT on IaaS and PaaS and SaaS and DaaS. Is everyone aware of those kinds of services? Because Oracle has an example of how you want to have your computer on premise, or do you want it in the cloud? You know, so you can choose between everything, but it's making you more indecisive because you don't know what makes sense and what is prudent. So, also in the language sphere, if you look at the big data, now there is a saying, in the old way, we only had data, real data. But if you look at this picture, you see the difference between business and IT. And the business is calling, I want all big data in my system. And the IT guy says, yeah, I'm just used to getting only real data, you know? So how are you going to solve that problem? Now, enough about spaghetti, and now more about solutions. And because of being an implementer, I was always looking at relationships and trying to build business processes. But in this case, with all those container disruptions, I want to have the relationship between those container disruptions. So I went to the site of the World Economic Forum, and they have a splendid overview. I don't know whether you heard it of all those global disruptions. So these are the disruptions. And this is the tutorial how to get there. It's open for anyone. You can just log in, and you can pinpoint any disrupting issue, put it in the center, and you see all the surroundings and the relationships. So if you don't know what a disruption will mean for your business, you can just pick one. For instance, we go to the next slide as an example. You see, for instance, cybersecurity. Everyone is talking about cybersecurity. So it's I think I need to do something about cybersecurity, everyone is thinking. But he doesn't know whether it involves his business process. So if you want to know the circumstances in which cybersecurity has influence on, then you can easily pick the relationship out of these kinds of models. What you also can do is you not only see a summarization, you see the key issues that are involved, you see also the publications, the experts, the events, and the initiatives, and the data. So I would really invite you to log in, and it's really dynamic because all the blue lines will appear on if you pinpoint one of those disruptions. This is an example of digital communications. So you know what the impact of digital communications will be. I will just flip a few more because I only have 5 minutes. The future of production, information technology, Internet of Things, social media, virtual and augmented reality. You can see all the relationships from those container disruptions or key issues. I would really advise you to look at that. Now, if we look global, you can also look personal. And personal means that also our brain is a spaghetti. You know, if you take the skull off, you see that there is partition, and you have a cerebrum, you have a cerebellum, you have the brainstem. So there is spaghetti outside, but there is also spaghetti inside. And if you look at the partition itself, you see that our brain is really organized. And you see also the different parts of the brain that is involved with certain, I call it, business processes of a human being. So you see the handling of certain business processes is evident. If you try to bring something more into the personal sphere, then I would rather invite you to see in how I analyze business transformation assessment, and I call it back to the bone. Back to the bone, on the left side you see only the bones, on the right side you see bones with flesh and muscles. But it's a method to have a good understanding of how you can analyze your business. I do that out of the point that as a person and also as a business, you have mission, vision, strategy, tactics, and operation, and you have your maintenance and your program project column. So those are the swimming lanes for not only a business or enterprise, but also for a person. So I'll start off with a person and the basic, the maintenance basics and the program basics we will discuss later, but I will first start with a person. If you are a person, you have your own, you know that there is not only two-dimensional, but also three- and four-dimensional. You set things out in time, and you set things out on location. And furthermore, if you look at the basic values, then it need not be your basic values, your values, but the empowerment can be that's God or that's someone who empowers you. But if that's not the case, for instance, with a business, it will be an investor. But I will try to make the connection between the person and the business. So be happy, become happy. That's a program. That's on a mission level. And you can fill out it yourself. So we skip the next page, because now we are going to the business side. I came to Metro Amsterdam, and we were building the North-South line. It's a huge project, 800 million in advance, and 3.2 billion in the end, to build a new metro line. And I was just figuring out, how can I put the spaghetti on place? So what I did is make use of the same same swimming lanes, and now you can see how you can drop any project or any maintenance operation on the plate, on this plate. So if you see what you can do here, is this is only metro and tram, but it can also be your organization. You can set it out also on time and location. And this is your assessment. you can put your name on the spot. You can do it as a person or as an organization. It doesn't really matter what you wanna fill in here. And if you are in a current situation, you try to change yourself. Now, sometimes you change your mission. You can see that here. Sometimes you change your vision. You change your vision, and what you get back from the project is a to-be vision. So, and it's also on strategy level. If you change your business process on the left side, you need a project that changes the business process, and you get it back in your maintenance column. Also said, if you change systems, then so the delta it cannot need not be only within one swimming lane. It can also be a combined delta. So this is an example of how you can also do it with partners. So if you see here, you can fill in GVB is the transporter on the metro line, and metro and tram is the infrastructure maintenance part. But you can also partner any operation in this view and make this assessment. You can also change the center, the center, so you can see for yourself if blue is your company, you see what goes over, and what goes over is important for you, but it can also influence your partner. And because you can also merge, if you have two partners, you have one new vision, you have one new strategy, you have one new tactics. So you can bring everything together. You can also put that in place for partners in the sense you are married or any couple. Yeah? And you can, as a couple, say, we can change each other, or you can change, or you can fill in whatever you want. So I want to make the comparison with a human being. Based on that, you can also explain a little bit more about four dimensions. If you have you have three locations. For instance, we had a lot of stations from the metro line, and we were not aware of what project on what location was involving another project on that location. So if you use this also for a location assessment, then you will not be in the same work area if you need your own scope to be implemented with not disturbing the other one's scope. This is based on location. But you can also do the roadmap on time. So you can do it on the short time, middle term, or the long term. And if you do it on the long term, you can see that if you want to go from A to B, what's in between, and you can just pick and choose your projects you want to implement to get there. So it's very visual. It's not... It combines all the aspects of, in this case, partners, GVB and Metro and Tram, but it can be any business. So that's a way of handling. In this case, you can also fill in different kinds of contracts. If you have a DCM contract, they call it, design, construct, and maintain contract, you can just fill in your vendors. For instance, we had an example that Siemens was the contractor, and they used subcontractors. On the program side and on the maintenance side, you can just very visually explain what kind of project is involved and how you involve your vendors. Now, this is another example of reference model, business processes, procedures, and work instructions. Be very clear about that. Make no distinct. Make no. You should. It's an advisor, so it's not a must. But I would recommend to be very clear about reference model, business processes, sub-procedures, and work instructions, and the level on which you describe things. It's, of course, this is especially based for large accounts, for big companies, to have your structure on place and on time. If you look at the market, this is a triangle which is really fits into this model, and it's based on the enterprise architecture. So I would advise you also to have your people well skilled when using enterprise architecture, and there are courses on that, not only on enterprise architect, but also CompTIA, it's a partner who's also performing here, is working on that, and they have their own certifications. Microsoft has them. There are lots of certifications to get your people involved. But I would really like to have you read these comments. These are not my comments, but they are out of a book, which I will I will show you in the next slide. But as an integrated architecture approach, now it is evident that you will need some structure, and this is what is explained in the slide. Sorry. Within an many different but related issues need to be addressed. Business processes should be contributed to an organization's products and services. Applications should support these processes. Systems and networks should be designed to handle the applications, and all of these should be in line with the overall goals of the organization. Now, this is really enterprise architecture text. So I have my reserve slides, but I also know that I'm over time, so I will skip that. But these are the books that you can order if you want to know more about bridging the gap between business and IT, because a solution lies within enterprise architecture. So I would like to end this this presentation, and if there are questions or sorry? Oh yeah, you can also speak me one-on-one if you want. So I can go deeper into enterprise architecture, but because of time, we stop here. Yeah? Okay, thank you very much.